这样，在讲我的作品之前，我还是要讲一讲这个会议的主题到五重这个地方啊。
Before I show you some of my works, I feel obliged to talk about 欧总。
昨天那个约翰尼先生把那个路易康的那个孟加拉的那个议会中心和五重的这个歌剧院排列在一起啊。
Yesterday, Professor Yohani Plasma juxtaposed Louis Kahn's Dhaka Parliament House and Uzong's Sydney Opera House.
我看见他们确实有相似之处啊。
I very much share the same view as Professor Plasma. They do share a lot of common ground, these two buildings.
昨天我才来到悉尼歌剧院，第一次看见。那十年前我去过那个。议会中心，卫康那个。
Yesterday, I made it to the Sydney Opera House the first time, but 10 years ago, I went to see Kahn's Parliament House.
我觉得他们的相似之处都是这样的，他们匍匐在当地的自然事物上，然后承载着本地意识的期待。
Gee, that's complicated.
他们趴在或者我们更具体的说。
Let me try. I feel the common ground these two buildings share is that both of these two buildings are deeply grounded and rooted in their site. However, what they are richly loaded is actually the culture or the spirit of the place. I hope I have done justice to his very complicated sentence.
路易康那个是趴在洪水泛滥的平原上，承载着一个有点宗教感应的神的那种向往，有点宗教感的。
You see, Kahn's building is very much grounded in a kind of plain that is flooded. So what is loaded by that building is more a sort of a religious feeling.
五重这个是趴在海面上，承载着那个扬帆的一种梦想啊。
Whereas Uzong's building is grounded in the harbor, so what is loaded in this building is the spirit of the sails.
作为一个从中国内陆深处来的建筑师，我也很熟悉这种感觉，我也很本能的，要把自己的建筑，放在土上、土地上，但是要承载什么，在这个飞速发展的中国，却是一个变化很快的事情。
Being someone who come from the inland of China, I'm very conscious about having my building very much grounded in its place. But what can be loaded in my building in today's China when things happen so fast? It's a big question.
我是2000年成立了自己的事务所。
I established my practice in the year 2000.
在此之前我很长时间都在做文学的写作。
Before that, I was a writer.
我那个，这是我成立事务所以后的一个比较重要的作品，叫《鹿野苑石刻博物馆》。
This is what I see as one of the more important works, and that was done, as you can see from the slide. Yeah.When it was built, it's a sculpture museum.
它的主题是佛教的石刻。
It houses Buddhist sculptures.
这是那个基地。
This is the site.
也是基地。
And another image of the site.
这个博物馆不大，就坐落在这个基地上。我是采用了那个。中国园林的办法，就是让他们绕来绕去，这样路线就会比较长啊。
Because it's a very small building, And the building has to be sited there. It's not a very big site. So what I've done is to try the approach where you have in a Chinese garden and you have to make the way a bit winding so that elongates the path to the building.
我把那个林间空地看成一个明亮的房子，我把那个竹林看成一个幽暗的大厅，我把建筑和这些空地树林都作为一个平等的因素来对待，这些建筑也是不是一个大房子，而是由很多小房子组合在一起。
So I've decided to see the open ground as a brightly lit hall, with the bamboo forest as a sort of dimly illuminated room. And I treat my buildings as separate rooms.
就人们在这样一个迂回的路线上不断地经过不同的空间，它会有一个比较丰富的感受。
So walking through that winding path, my hope is to enrich their spatial experience.
那这是模型。
This is the model.
这是房子的组合，你看它其实是由一些小房子聚集在一起的，这样就不需要开窗，就只用房子之间的缝隙采光通风就够了。
Because I see this building as a collection of small rooms, and so I do not need to have windows. I just need to use the gaps in between the rooms to get the daylight.
在我们那儿有一个不成文的规矩，就是你占了农民的地，买了农民的地，就还要由当地的农民来帮你盖房子。这样他虽然失去了土地，但是他可以通过盖房子还可以挣点钱。
In my province, there's this unspoken rule. If you occupy the agricultural land, and you must give the construction job to the local peasants so that they can actually get something in return.
因为是由农民来盖房子，所以我不能先自己想了一个怎么做，然后让他们去做。而是我要先了解他们能做到什么程度，然后我再来调整我的设计。
Because the farmers are not skilled labor, and what I can do is to see what they are capable of doing. And once I understand that, and I begin to design my building.
这是在做工地的，跟他们一块做实验。
This is my construction experiment.
因为是佛教的时刻的主题，我想用混凝土这个主题来和它呼应。
Because the museum is a Buddhist sculpture museum, so I think naturally concrete is the most fitting material.
我们那儿的农民是从来没有做过混凝土的。
But the farmers in that place had never used the concrete before.
但是他们去过砖，所以我就想了一个办法，就让他们先砌砖，这个他们能去得直。
But they could lay bricks, so I thought what I should do is to let them lay bricks first, because they can make sure it's a straight wall.
然后用砖来作为内膜，然后在外面再用木板作为外膜，这样他们就能够做到垂直。
So once this brick wall is erected, and I set up the wood mold, and that is the mold for the concrete.
然后再在里边浇灌混凝土。
So in situ the concrete is poured in.
然后让它们连接起来，成为一个复合的墙。
So that is the hybrid wall.
它那个打开了是这个样子。
So after you take away the timber molds, that's what you see. That's the texture you get.
这样就用那个土的办法来做成一个现浇混凝土的这样的一个效果。
So this is a very primitive approach to do the in situ concrete.
这是在工地的情况。
This is the construction site.
可以看见它是 先砌一节砖，然后再来浇混凝土。
So you can see, and they erect the brickworks first, and then they do the concrete after that.
这是完工的外貌。
So this is the completed project.
这是从这是进去，就是进入这个园子的路啊。
This is the entry path.
这个景观也是我做的。
I have also designed the landscape.
我没有学过景观。但是我观察到一件事情，就是从来没有人骂树，因为人是猴子变过来的。
I never studied the landscape architecture, but what I have observed is that trees are totally innocent because people never blame trees, and, because we were monkeys after all.
所以我就是尽量不砍一棵树，不会做了就种一棵树。
So my approach is to avoid cutting trees, and but if I run out of ideas, I just plant more trees.
这是林间空地和那个室外展场。
So this is the outdoor sculpture garden and the ground.
有个水塘，我就经过做了一个坡道，就过这个水塘，这是入口。
So there's this existing pond. So what I've done is to make a ramp as the entry.
这是从进去以后反过去看。
This is a view. This is viewing out from inside the entry ramp.
这个墙就是砖墙的抹白，它就缝隙透进来的光就在它上面反射，它其实室内，也就足够明亮啊。
So the whitewashed wall is a brick wall painted, and as you can see, the gap between the wall and the ceiling, that's where you get light in, and that's quite sufficient.
这是一些采光的一些照片。
So as you can see from the different views in the interior, you can see the quality of the light and where you get them from the gaps.
这是一个水池。前面的厅的光线可以透过这个，透过一个离地不高的一个缝隙，然后进入水池，又反射到另外一个厅。
So this pond in the room is used to reflect the light into the room.
这是天窗采光。
And there's some skylights, as you can see.
这也是。天窗，这个缝隙使室内外联系起来。
This is the slit skylight, and the gap is the connection between the room and the outside.
这是另外一种采光方式，就是在就看那个墙上那个薄板，其实是这样的，就是如果用顶光会显得比较庄严，如果用侧光会比较戏剧性，如果用三面光就会显得很安详，而安详是佛的本意。
All right. So if you use the top light, that will look very solemn. If you use the light coming from the side, that may be more dramatic. But if you have more diffused light from, let's say, three different directions,And the Buddhist statue look very calm, and that's what I wanted to achieve.
这是院子。
Roof garden, entry and exit.
这是房顶啊。
This is the roof.
房顶的水景也是景观的问题。我也是注意到，只要有水，怎么都好看。但关键的问题是没水的时候好不好看，所以我就是在上面放些石头啊，如果没水的时候，它们也会好看一些。有水，它就成为那个走来走去的那个厅部。
Yeah, this is the roof terrace, roof garden, and again, I have learned it's always good to have water.But when there is no water, and you need to do something, so that's why I have placed some pieces of the stone and stepping stones there. And when it is dry, it's still a sculpture garden.
这是落水管，其实就是把阴沟立起来。
This is the downpipe, and this is just the insertion. Yeah.
这是景观，因为它的地层本身是这个样子。我做的景观很简单，就是把地下的东西翻到地上来。
So this is basically the site, and my landscape is very simple. So what I have excavated, I just lay them on the ground, and that's the landscape design.
这是用钢筋做的栏杆。
And this is the fence.
是跟当地的那个用竹子做篱笆是一个道理。
Which is the same pattern as the bamboo fence.
这是另外一个项目啊。
This is another project. Yeah.
在南京，是一个国际性的合作项目。
And this is in a city called Nanjing, and it was a more sort of an international collaboration project.
这个项目是由我和日本的那个Isozaki来策划。
The whole project was planned by Isozaki and myself.
我们在世界各地请了
We invited about 20 architects from around the world.
Isozaki 做会议中心，我做酒店，意大利的，叫他做娱乐中心 ，Steven 或者做那个展览中心。
So Isozaki got the job of building the conference center, and I have the guest rooms, the hotel.And there's an Italian architect, the name I didn't get it. 这个意大利建筑设计什么？
娱乐中心。
It's an entertainment center, and the Stephen Hall has got.
那是展览中心。
The exhibition center. Yeah.
剩下二十块地其实是由中国十个建筑师和外国十个建筑师来做的。
And there are 20 more sites, and we have invited another 10 Chinese architects, another 10 foreign architects.To let them each design a building.
有很多有名的建筑师了。我记得这块地好像是那个 Sigma 的。
There are some big names, and I can remember that particular site has been given to Sigma.
这块地是一个澳大利亚的帅哥。建筑师，我已经记不起他的名字。
And that one particular site has been given to a very handsome Australian architect, and his name has escaped me.
这是南京郊外的村落的情况。
This is the villages you see at the outskirts of the city of Nanjing. Yeah.
我也把我要做的这个建筑做成，我想把这个酒店做成一个村落的情况。
So my hotel, I just wanted to build a village.
是这样的，我把那个我是在一个山谷和一个山包上，这是我的用地。
So my site is a valley, is a kind of valley and bound by a small hill.
我把那个
little house.
然后在走道上都能通过间隙可以看到外面的景色。
So all these gaps will give you the relief, will give you the view.
这是模型，你看看，它像一个那个村落啊。
So as you can see from this model, and this is my village.
还没有完全还室内设计还没完全完工。
The construction is not quite completed yet. They are still doing the interior.
这是 Stephen Hall 做的展览中心。
That's Stephen Hall's exhibition center.
现在已经在使用。
No, it's already in use. Yeah.
这是那个娱乐中心，意大利人做的娱乐中心。
That's the entertainment center by.By the Italian architect again, from the name. Yeah.
这个还没有使用，没有使用的原因是，意大利人做的那个娱乐没有中国人的娱乐疯狂，那个，所以业主就总觉得，闲冷，有点冷清哈，不好。
This has not been used at all. The main reason is because the clients feel this is too austere. The Chinese entertainment is much more rowdy. Yeah.
So
this is, shall I say, a large platform and a village on top of that platform.
在中国，黑白灰是一个传统的一个邻居的色彩。
In China, the color palettes of the villages are basically black and white and gray.
但是他们是以墙、屋顶这样的一个构建性的方式来表现的，而我在这里是黑房子、白房子、灰房子这样的一个。
But in the Chinese vernacular, the color palette is actually manifested in one single building. That's wall, roof, didn't get the third one. But in my case, I just use different materials for different buildings.
Yeah. 这是一个在四川美院的一个雕塑系，一个教学楼。
This is a faculty building, sculpture department, in Sichuan Fine Art, Academy of Fine Arts in Sichuan Province.
这是他的用地。他的问题是，他只有1000平方米的用地，但是他要2000平方米的天光教室。
Well, they only have 1,000 square meters, but they wanted 2,000 square meters of the skylight for the sculpture department.
Yeah.
As you can see, this. Sorry, go ahead. Yeah. In the show.
Yeah. 顶层是天光教室，然后又挖了一个大洞，这一层又可以作为天光教室。
So my solution is like this. As you can see, the top one they get the skylight.But I punched the holes to get more skylight to the lower levels.
这个在重庆的那个规划局的规定里边，就是因为这儿挨着一个比较近的房子，它就有一个退后的那个规定。但是过了超过那个附近的房子的高度以后，它就没有明确的条文，所以我又把那个房子往外扩张出来，斜出来，以便争取更大的那个天光面积。所以这不是形式，主要是争取面积。
In that particular city, Chongqing, and the planning rules about the setback, and there's a limit of the height. So as you can see, after that height limit, and they don't have particularly rules, they have not thought about that. So what I have done, this is not form making, and I obey the planning rules to have sufficient setback. But after the height limit, and I come out just to get more skylight.
这是一种，因为重庆非常热，这也是从我从当地学到的一种那种降温的方式，其实就是两层墙，这一层外面有孔洞，风进去以后又出来，啊，就形成立面上的这样一些孔洞，这样对降温非常有效果。
Summer in Chongqing is extremely hot, so what I have done is to create the perforated wall as the first layer.So that I can actually create some ventilation in the wall to cool the wall.
这个建筑使用了两种主要的材料，一种是那个就手工的去抹灰，另外一种是就用铝板。因为他是美术学院的，让版画系的学生去俯视了他一下啊。
As you can see, the surface materials are basically two. One is sort of backed or rendering, and the other one is aluminum cladding, but they are the etched aluminum plates done by their students, so they do etching. Yeah.
在中国，学生和那个工人都是人工很便宜的资源。
In China, students and construction workers they are inexpensive.
如果在欧洲可能会这样做很贵，但恰恰在中国这样做就很便宜。
I understand if you try this in Europe and other parts of the world, and that will increase your cost.
这个铝板其实做起来非常简单，但后来成为了这个学校的校办工厂的一个很好卖的一个产品。
This is actually a quite simple thing to do, but later the university has realized that this is a money-making opportunity, so they have their own local factory to produce the etched aluminum plates. Yeah.
因为别人不知道是怎么做的。
And to other people, it's a bit mystery. How did they actually do it?
这是在这是一个博物馆，一群博物馆。我在其中做了规划。然后又在其中做一个馆的。
This is a collection of many museums, and I was responsible for the planning of that. But I have also designed one particular building. Yeah.
这个项目的矛盾是，这个业主既是开发商又是收藏家。
The problem of this particular project is that the client is both the developer and the collector.
他两样事情都想做，他又想做那个博物馆，他又想做房地产开发。他的想法是让博物馆把人吸引人流，然后人来了以后，他的那个房地产开发就可以赚钱。
He wanted both. He wanted his development. He also wanted his collection. So his thinking is to use the museums to attract people to his commercial development.
这在中国也是没有办法的事情，因为它是民间的博物馆。
In China, that's what you have to do because these are all private money.
所以我要面对一个协调好商业和文化的关系的这样一个问题。
So my challenge was to coordinate the commercial part of the building and the museum.
这是一个古镇的开发，然后在古镇里边，主要是商业了。然后在里边有一些博物馆，我负责的是这个红色的这一块。
The site is in a very old town, ancient town, and the red part is actually my site.
我注意到在传统中国的那种关系里边，就是庙宇，是信仰生活的，然后庙宇周围总是有很多什么卖香火的、吃饭的这样一个世俗生活的围绕啊，其实这是一个很古老的关系。
I have observed in China every temple which is supposed to be the more religious part of the activity, but it's always surrounded by shopping and commercial activities.
所以我就把那个这个用地的周围全部都做成那个商业。
So I have decided to surround the museums with shops.
而商业不要的那个中间的地块，我来做成博物馆。
But the core of the site, the core of the three sites.Are not good for shops, so I use them as my museum.
这个铁的部分就是博物馆的部分，而周围的就是商业的部分，所以我把它叫做历史的和现实的肉啊。
As you can see, the cores, this sort of cotton steel look cores, are the museums, and the rest of that is commercial.And I've given them two particular terms, 历史的肉，
历史的河，
历史的河，and 现实的
肉。
All right. The core is the history, and the flesh is the reality. Yeah. It's a literal translation.
周边是用混凝土框架结构做的，可以他们商业使用的时候随便改造。而那个里边的中心的这个是用红砖来做的，是让它不变。
All right. The flash is built with the mixture of concrete frames and other infill materials, but the cores are purely brick structure.
跟一般建筑师特别注意这个外立面的什么造型不同，我是几乎是我觉得是我放弃外立面的设计，就让商业它想怎么样就怎么样
啊。So unlike the concerns that most architects have, that is your facade and elevation, and I do not care about what the shops actually will look like, and I only worry about the core of these museums.
因为很多建筑师是这样的，就是把自己的房子造好以后赶紧去拍照，因为过不了几天那个进来用的人就会把它改变了啊。
As you know, many of our architect friends, and once the building is completed, they would rush to go and take photographs because they know after a little while the buildings will be spoiled by human activities.
然后建筑师就去骂这些使用的人。
And then architects blame the users.
但是他没有意识到其实他自己成了生活的敌人。
And what they have not realized that is that they have become the enemy of life.
这是入口。
This is the entry.
入口就是用红砖来做，因为红砖是这个文化大革命期间的那个时代的那个典型的材料。
The entry, as you can see, the large area of red bricks, and the museum is the museum of the Chinese Cultural Revolution. And red bricks were the primary building materials during that period of time.
其实这些外边其实都是那个商店。
And what you can see beyond the entry, there are all shops.
这是连接起几个的那个通道。
These are the passageways that will take you to the core.
这是进入以后的一个陈列关于文中的一个展厅，就其实是在一个通道里。
This is part of the passageway and part of the museum. And this particular museum is designed to house the clocks from that particular period of time.
这些钟都还能响。但是每一个时间都不一样，他们陈列的方式跟那个佛龛的那个，就中国那些佛龛的方式是相似的。
All these clocks are in working order, but they are in different times, and the way they have been placed in those sort of niches, and they are not dissimilar to the Buddhist sculptures.
进去以后，转了甬道进去以后，其实是一个圆形的院子。
So after you walked past that passageway museum, you walk into this courtyard.
因为我想钟其实就是跟按古代的，就是跟声音和光影有关，这是古代的计时的方式。
So the ancient type of the clock is really about the sun path and perhaps the sound.
就是这个圆形的院子。
So this is this drum-like courtyard.
因为是圆形的，所以当你站在中间说话的时候，会觉得自己的那个自己就像一口钟，声音很好啊。
Because of its shape, so when you stand in the middle, when you talk, and the echo will actually make you feel you're part of the clock.
我站在中间唱过歌，我感觉好像回到了大学时代，在那个男生宿舍卫生间里边那种感觉。
I actually tried to sing in that courtyard, and that sort of sensation has taken me back to my university days when I actually sang in the toilet.
这是另外一个空间啊。
This is another room.
这个空间本来设计是，要在上面挂上那个红卫兵的旗子啊。
It was designed to have all these flags from the Red Guard Red Guards flags from the Chinese Cultural Revolution to be hung from the ceiling.
但是红卫兵这个事情在中国还是一个非常敏感的事情，所以到现在也没有敢挂，只是在旁边都是当年的报纸。
Because the actually phenomena of the Red Guards and the Chinese Cultural Revolution to this day are still sensitive matters in China. So up to this point, we still do not dare have these flags actually hung from the ceiling. So what we have done is to have all these newspapers stored in the shelves.
如果有一天它能挂出来，那个天光透过红旗，就会使这个整个厅变得比较有很红啊。
One day when we are able to hang these flags, you can envisage the skylight filtered through the moving red flags, and the whole room will be animated.
也许有那么一天。
I hope that day will come.
这是另外一个厅，它是用来陈列那个当时那些组织的那个印章的啊，本来是这样的啊。
This is another room. Which is designed to house the sort of work units, stamps, and chops, a collection of them. Yeah.
因为印章关系权力嘛，我是把它设计成一个好像就是教室一样的，老师站在上面就有话语权，就是那这样。
Because
但是到现在成了一个有点像毛泽东的小教堂，因为印章也不让展出。
All right, because every stamp, every chop, you know, signifies power, and so I have designed this room pretty much like a classroom. So whoever is the teacher has the speech right, and but now we are still not allowed to have these stamps and chops.As part of the exhibition, we only have Chairman Mao there. Yeah.
这是周围的情况。虽然他可能建筑师觉得他不一定好看，但是他很重要。他在这些商业的活动在养活这个博物馆。
These are the shops, and they may not look like architectural, but they are very important. And these are the kind of activities that will make the museum going.
就是2008年5月12号四川发生了一场特别大的地震，死了倒塌了很多房子，死了10万人。
五月多少号？
五月二。
五月二。On the 12th of May 2008, there was this massive earthquake happened in Sichuan province.
大量的废墟啊，我看见有大量的废墟，这些废墟很难处理，这是一件，这是一方面。另外一个就是，在地震以后有很多房子需要重新建设啊。
So two major problems after the earthquake. One is the massive scale of the rubbles, and the other problem is to rebuild the houses very quickly.
我就想到把这些废墟打碎了，重新来造砖啊。
So what I've done is to crush the rubbles and then make them as recycled bricks. Not bricks, blocks. Yeah.
当地有很多这种手工的小作坊，我就利用它们来重新造砖。
There are many small workshops, and we just use them to make this concrete blocks with the crushed rubbles.
他们也可以通过这种生产来自救。
So they make a living out of that.
这是造出来的第一批砖。
So this is the first batch. Yeah.
在地震之后，其实这个事情已经越出了地震，因为中国有很多那个城市的拆迁，也有很多这样的那个建筑垃圾啊。
But that particular approach is now beyond earthquake in Sichuan in China, and it's actually a problem throughout the country where you have massive demolition of the buildings and the rubbles as a result of that.
受到刚才那个砖的启发，政府和企业都很感兴趣，于是就建了那个机械化的厂。
So the government have noticed that, and they liked that idea, and they have set up factories to produce the recycled concrete blocks.
就是生产的，就是我研究生产的，各种各样的那个砖。
This is a variety of the concrete blocks, and according to his design, according to my design, yeah.
可以看见他们里边那些碎的红的什么瓷砖啊砖啊那些碎渣啊。
So as you can see, yes, the crushed rubbles can be seen from there.
当时我还在生产，就正是2008年，所以就被威尼斯双年展选中，就去做了个展览。
So in that particular year, I was invited to put up an exhibit at the Venice Biennale.
这是农民购买我们那个砖自己盖的房子。
So the farmers actually use that sort of concrete blocks to build their buildings now.
这是我们重建村落，我们去重建村落也是用这个砖。
And we have built the houses with the recycled concrete blocks, the same material.
这个砖已经用到了一些，现在已经用到一些公共建筑上。
Now we are using them in public buildings.
这是其中一个纪念的院子。
This is one of the buildings.
这是我给那个瑞士一个企业在上海的总部的办公楼，叫 Novartis 这个企业啊，他们也很。选用了这个砖，他们觉得是很符合那个环保的概念。
So when I was asked to design the headquarters of Novartis, a Swiss company in Shanghai, and they very much liked the idea of using this sort of concrete blocks because it's perceived as environmental friendly.
这个房子是会在今年年底建成。
This building should be completed by the end of this year.
这是已经建成的，就去年年底已经建成的，用再生砖做的第一个公共建筑，它是一个博物馆。
And this was completed last year, yeah, using the same material.
就是我把砖敲断了以后，它里面的那个骨料就暴露出来了。
So we smashed the concrete blocks to get that texture. Yeah.
刚才讲的是地震。以后关于物的，我做的关于物质的一个事情，另外一件事情是又不一样啊。
Now what I have just told you from that particularly earthquake are the more material side of the project. I mean this is something quite different. This new approach.
这是关于人的。
This is more to do with the human being.
这个小女孩叫胡慧山，她是。死的，他们地震死的时候15岁。
This girl, his name is Hu Huishan. When she was killed in the earthquake, she was 15 years old.
地震死了，我们不知道死了多少学生。据说有几千，也说有10000啊。但是不管是多少，对政府来说就是一个数字，他们连名单都没有。
We don't know. We don't know exactly how many students were killed in that earthquake. And some say thousands, some say tens of thousands. But to the government, they are names on a list. And in fact, we don't even have the name lists.
一直到现在都是数字。老百姓在政府的眼里总是一个数字。
Until now, it's just a figure.
我是在这个地震的废墟上，认识了他的父母。
I came to know her parents when I was when I was on site.
我给了他们一些钱，但是我觉得是没有用的，因为他们都不想活了。
I donated some money to them, but it was totally useless because they had lost any hope for life.
我就做一个建筑师嘛，我最擅长的就是盖房子。后来我就想，能不能给他们，给他女儿盖一个人的纪念馆，因为中国从来没有给普通人盖纪念馆的这样的一个事例。
I'm an architect. All I can do is to build, and so I thought whether or not I could build a memorial hall for that little girl, because in China, an ordinary person never gets opportunity to have a memorial building.
帐篷是地震期间的集体记忆。
So the collective memory of the aftermath of the earthquake is tent.
我就设计了这个跟帐篷一样大的一个纪念馆。
So I have designed a building which is exactly the same shape as a tent.
这是非法的，建立这纪念馆非法的。我是在我朋友的一块地上找了一个小树林。
It is illegal to build a memorial hall for a common person, and I have used a piece of land from a friend's property, and I have built this illegal building.
这个博物馆外表是最朴素的一个灰色，而里边是那个小女孩生前喜欢的粉红色。
The outside of that simple building, as you can see, is austere and simple, but the interior is pink and the favorite color of the girl when she was alive.
我稍微改了一下帐篷，它有一个天光进来的彩。
So the only thing I've changed is to allow skylight into this tent.
这都里面都是他父母给我的他的遗物。
So these are the things her parents have given them to me.
这个博物馆虽然盖好了，但是政府不允许开放。
The memorial hall has been completed, but we have not been permitted, not been given the permission to actually open it by the government.
所以我只好在门上反着安了一个那个猫眼。
So the only thing I can do is to have a peep hole on the door.
这样人们就可以这样去看。
So people can peep into that museum.
昨天我跟那个约翰先生谈那个诗，你在问的诗和史诗，我这么想。这本身只是我和这个小女孩和她父母一个人的事情啊。如果允许开放的话，就是一个人的事情，那只是诗。但如果总是不让开放，甚至把它拆掉的话，它有可能变成史诗。
Yesterday I was trying to have a conversation with Professor Plasma about poetry and epics. I thought, you know, this building is a very individual thing between myself and the parents of that girl. But one day, if that is demolished by the government, whether or not that will become epic.
这是一个关于大熊猫的一个项目。
This is a project about the big pandas, big pandas.
这熊。要在那个一个就山坡上给熊猫修建一个熊猫生产的一个产房产科医院。
So they wanted to build a reproduction place for big pandas.
我是用一个环形的墙把这个产房保护起来，然后其实周围都是那个混乱的那个树林，我。上面用那个单一的竹子把它种上，这样它其实能和周边有一个明显的区别，但是它又是植物的。
So I have protected and surrounded the big pandas reproduction with a wall, but I have also built a bamboo fence to separate it from the rest of the vegetation.
后来人们叫它熊猫寨，因为寨就是那个熊猫的产地，那个羌族、藏族的那些地方的一个普遍的方式。
And later on, this has been given a nickname as the Big Panda Castle.
Yeah. 人们可以在这个路上去看熊猫。
So if people are curious about Big Panda's reproduction, they can actually peep into that on that elevated walkway.
这个索桥也是进入它的通道，其实也是熊猫产地常见的一个，他们那边的桥就这样的。
This is actually one of the bridges they built in the conservation area.
毛泽东的战略是农村包围城市。我好像也这样，一直在乡村里面做事情，后来我们现在也可以进城做一些事情。
Chairman Mao's military tactic is to use the countryside to surround the city, to besiege the city, and I more or less use the same approach.
这是在一个新城 新的那个高楼林立的中心。
So this is a sort of empty ground in the middle of a high-rise jungle.
周围都是高楼。我想其实这个概念也普通，就是说把房子盖了，把屋顶开放出来，成为一个公共用地，公共公园。
My concept is very simple. Since we have the build there, we might as well just make the roof and as the park, yeah, landscape park.
这个屋顶很受人欢迎，有经常有人开会啊，小孩在那玩。
So as you can see that roof garden has been a very popular place for the locals.
它的下面是美术馆。
And the buildings are actually museums, art museums.
我要给最后一个项目，我要给大家说我现在正在做的一个事情。
So the last project I would like to show to you today is a project that I'm actually doing right now.
这是社会主义大院一个原型哈。
This is the socialist collective big compound.
这是成都人，就是很普遍的一个成都生活。
This is what the locals do in that particular place. Yeah.
这是一块很奇怪的一个用项目啊，它的地很大，因为周边都是住宅，它以前只是一个社区公园，有一些体育啊，有些休闲的体育。
This project is peculiar. It's a very large piece of land, but it was a sort of neighborhood. Park with some sports facilities.
但是它的吸引力不够，所以就想做一些增加一些建筑，但是同时又要保持它的那个社区绿地和那个体育公园的那个性质。
But the current sports ground and the park is not terribly appealing, and the developer wanted to make it. More popular, but in the meantime, they have to build.
我的策略是把房子盖围着周边盖一圈，使里边的绿地最大化。
So my approach is to build around the periphery and to maximize the ground in the middle.
房子里边的功能是非常混杂的。
So it's a truly hybrid building. There are all sorts of things happening there.
另外，因为要保持体育，又用了一个跑道，它可以上到屋顶啊。
Because the sports facilities are very important as part of this development, so I have built this ramp system for people to jog and ride bicycles.
所以它的混杂性就非常强啊。
As you can see, how hybrid it is.
这是工作模型。
This is working model.
这是总平面。
Side plan.
这是在那个实景嵌入的一个效果图。
This is a rendering.
它的屋顶都是可以上去，都是可以休息。 自行车也可以骑到屋顶。
So you can ride your bike to the roof.
屋顶我们用那个大孔砖，摆在那里，大孔砖里填上土，还可以种东西。
So we have used a lot of hollowed concrete blocks on the roof where soil can be put in and you can green them.
下面是有些球场。
And they are sports grounds.
因为它有球场。这是那个可以上去的那个跑道啊。
Ramps。
这是院子里的那个全部种竹子，我是因为是在成都，全部种竹子，就可以竹子下面有各种各样的活动。
Because it's in Chengdu, I just use bamboos throughout. It's all bamboos.
可以在竹林围绕的小院子里边开那个开会。
So these are the kind of areas and you can actually rent to have a meeting there.
这些都拉开来可能就是这样的电视啊，关上去可以当黑板，当然可以开会，也可以在里边干什么都可以。
So you can have a screen hidden behind a blackboard.
可以在这儿运动，有些演出。
Sports and performances can happen spontaneously.And shops.
也有那个外挂的楼梯，可以从下面一直上到屋顶。
Yeah, there are also a lot of outdoor staircases.
也可以做露天展出。
Exhibitions can be set up there in those verandas.
这个那一圈房子里边又有酒店，又有餐饮，又有书店。还有办公。
So there are hotels and restaurants and offices and all sorts of activities in that particularly complex.
我给大家放一个三分钟的那个工地的录像，可以了解一下中国是怎么盖房子的。
I'm going to show you a 3-minute video and just to let you know how things are actually built in China.
这女的是工程负责人。
She is in charge of the entire construction, that lady.
就到这里，谢谢。
Thank you very much.